Having managed to talk our way past the first set of officials, we're joined by another car.
So these are our security guys. So they're going to be following us. So do we stop or do we just keep going?
No, we're not going to stop.
It seems that the people we've entrusted ourselves to are well connected at the border. So far, so good.
Welcome to Alma.
So there we go. We're into Yemen, into Al Mahra governorate, and we made it across. No passport stamps required.
After the Arab Spring, Yemen descended into chaos, and there is no one group controlling power. Iranian-sponsored Houthis have taken the capital, Sana'a. Saudi Arabia has backed the ousted Sunni leader, and Al-Qaeda control the central mountains. We've just entered the Al Mahra region. And to continue my journey through Yemen, I'm going to need the help of the Sultan. Sultan Abdullah bin Essa bin Ali Al-Afra is the tribal leader of Al Mahra region in the east of Yemen. His ancestors have ruled here since the 15th century. And in a country like Yemen, you need to have powerful friends.
We would like to ask your permission to travel through Mahara and meet the people that live here.
Of course.
That would be very helpful.
نحن سنتصل على الأخ الوكيل لكن المشكلة إيش إمكانياته هو هل يقدر يأمنهم ولا لا لأن المحافظة حضرموت فيها خليط من البشر.
I'm heading west, and with the Sultan's blessing, I will travel towards the border of the Hadramat. The next morning, we begin our journey further west, which has been hit hard by the war.
Nothing moves fast here in Yemen.
We've got less than 100 kilometres before reaching lawless Hadramat. And having still not received word from the Sultan that we'll be safe to carry on, we get some troubling news.
So the same border that we came in is now closed?
That's what they say, but we can get out.
Oh, shit. Yeah, how do we get out there?
Following a rocket attack on Riyadh from Houthi rebels, the Saudis have closed all of Yemen's borders, including the one we came through.
Well, that's not good news. And what about the port here, if we can just get a boat and leave immediately or as soon as possible?
There is a boat that needs to go to the Somaliland.
Basically, hit a bit of a brick wall. Going forward through Yemen is impossible. The Saudis have now closed all of the borders, official ones and unofficial ones. So it looks like the only option is to basically get on a boat from one of the ports here and go to the Horn of Africa. It seems like it's madness, but it's the only way to get out of Yemen at this stage.
To compound our fears, it seems word of our presence in Yemen has spread.
Just had some disturbing news. Basically, our security guys have just said that they were approached by the Yemeni National Intelligence Unit, who are not affiliated to this area at all, but they said they want to come here and get my name out and Dave's name as well, so they can report back. This is not good. We need to get in the car and hide out for a bit.
Yep.
So we're on the move. We've had to change vehicles now into a different one to move to a different location. We're told that the hotel has been compromised and the Yemeni intelligence services know exactly where I am. So we're just driving around town now, just sort of trying to hopefully shake them off our tail.
in the safe room?
Safe enough. Safe enough.
Next morning, there's no sign of the secret police, but we're informed there's threat of a Saudi attack. Now, we just need to get out of the country. With all options evaporating, I'm beginning to think we have no way out. Then, we get a call. The Sultan has been given special permission to cross the border back into Oman. And if we race to the border, he's agreed to try and smuggle me back with him.
Okay, we've got a button.
Come on. Are we
going to
get out?
Yeah.
Hello, Sultan. How are you? Thank you.
We've met up with the Sultan's convoy, and the plan now is to travel with them all the way up to the Oman border, down to Salalah. And this seems to be the only way that I can get out of Yemen. Because I don't have a stamp in my passport to say that I'm here. We have to basically zoom through the checkpoint straight through immigration. No stamps, but when you've got a number plate like this, people don't tend to ask questions.
The road is so bad.
Are the guys allowed to take weapons into a man?
No.
They're all on to the teeth, though. What? I'm going to film, just go through this bit and then I'll turn it off.
At the border, we're stopped and interrogated by Omani officials and our vehicles searched. After 5 hours of negotiation, we're allowed through.